at the cross where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I'm happy all the day. Alas, and did my Savior bleed, and did my Sovereign die. It is so humbling to see that Jesus put his face towards Jerusalem. Sure, it was fulfillment of prophecy, but it was also a place of greatest battle. He was going to face suffering in Jerusalem, a place of rejection and mockery, a place of physical death. But thank God, there was also going to be a resurrection in Jerusalem. This was the epic battle for restoration. And at the cross in Jerusalem, there was victory. There was victory like no other victory that has ever taken place in the universe. So you see, I don't want my mind to miss the greatest truth. The struggle at the cross, the surrender at the cross that my Jesus took for my sake, for your sake. Isaiah would say, surely he has borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we esteem him stricken, smitten by God and afflicted. But he was pierced for our transgression, he was crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the chastisement that brought us peace, and with his wounds we are healed. Without Jerusalem, without cross, without a place of surrender, you and I will still be in our sin and waiting for the judgment. So as you begin to think about this season of Easter, I just want you to think about the cross, a place of surrender, and how it came about. In the book of Revelation, Jesus is called the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Yet he humbled himself even to take the death on the cross. For you, for me. I have really never taken time to think that it was my sin, that would take Jesus to the cross in Jerusalem. Have you taken time to think that it was your sin? And yet today we will still think that he was smitten of God, without realizing the truth. It was for you. It was for me. He went to Jerusalem to take up the cross. You see, the cross is a place of surrender. I will leave this question with you. Have you come to the cross? Have you come to the place of surrender? Father, we thank you for your grace, your mercy, and your love. We thank you for your goodness and for your kindness, that you would send your only begotten Son to take my place on the cross of Calvary. That he would take all my sin and he would bear my sin upon the cross. Lord, this is beyond and above. A mind can capture. But Lord, I would pray that the Spirit take your truth and open my eyes and my heart and my mind and open the eyes and heart of your people, that we would understand what Christ accomplished. The cross of Calvary in Jerusalem for me, for us. Thank you for your grace. Lord, that you may also bring me to the place of surrender to my Lord and Savior.